Yeah, those two zeros after the rough start ended up being very big, but not many times are you going to dig a hole to those guys and get out of it. Our bullpen was magnificent again, got our bats rolling, and obviously, you know, you don't want the game to get on the terms of trying to beat their guys at the end, but worked out that way. We got some hits off of Betances to, you know, to get it done. But you know, Jesse was really off early, just not only the walks, but the bad counts, you know, not being able to put guys away. I think he came out in the third and fourth and just found his release point better and got us two innings.
You guys seem to have a lot of opposite field hits tonight. I mean, did you like sort of the approach or guys like just trying to get the game even with homers?
I think we did a good job of runners in scoring position. I mean, 5 for 9, so some of those hits are going to be opposite field when they fall in. But you know, Albert got two the other way. Eske got one the other way. I think we did a good job with runners in scoring position. A good job running the bases. The whole comeback was done without a ball going out of the park. So, you know, that was impressive.
What about the bullpen, Mike?
Yeah, these guys just keep doing it, and Petit was fresh, so you know he got us a couple. But the rest of the guys, you know, even though they were off last night, have been pitching a lot, and they came out tonight, and they were throwing the ball very well, and you know, shut them down.
Considering all the injuries you've had out there, you've had a pretty good run out of these guys, huh?
These guys have been terrific. I mean, we're, like I said, like 500 is nothing to, you know, throw a parade about. But I don't think we're even 500 without the job that our pen's done from start to finish or start to this point of the year. So, you know, it's like a little eclectic. Some names are, you know, not household names down there, but they're all throwing the ball very well.
How would you describe the mental impact on pitchers of what Cam Maven creates when he's on the bases? It seems like there's been a lot of mistakes that he's induced in recent weeks, just in standing near first base.
Not only Cam, but I think we've got some depth in our running game, and you saw where Simba yesterday, you know, forced a balk. You know, he threw a ball away today. And Cam is certainly, I mean, Cam is leading that charge, no doubt, but I think our whole team has been able to do some things on the base paths that have helped us to create a little bit of offense and manufacture some runs. And a guy like Cam, you certainly got to pay some attention to
him. It's not that this stolen base threat as a team wasn't there when Trout was here, but it seems like it has emerged to some degree greater since his injury. Do you envision retaining that upon his return?
Yeah, I think, you know, I think we've been pretty, you know, calculating about when we're running, and I think we're doing a good job picking some spots. But you know, Mike will just accentuate what these guys have been doing, and these guys are doing a good job of getting their reads and getting their jumps. And you know, we've not only stolen base, but like you're talking about, some, you know, force some issues and force some mistakes, hopefully. And you know, we need to keep doing that.
How much has this team grown in the last 4 weeks and learned about itself just in the time without Trout and being able to do this without him and having 12 and 11 without him?
I don't know. I'm not real big on doing introspective of a team.